look at this mess, you can see mangled metal behind me. That is actually the frame of a burnt out truck. We had even trouble finding it. Police are now involved in this investigation. They are going door to door, talking to neighbors, asking what they saw, what they may have heard, just trying to figure out what happened, though they are not calling this fire suspicious at this time. We talked to people, they just want to know what happened. Around 3:30 this morning, Donna Merlo woke up to an orange sky.
I happened to look out my window and saw the flames and saw the smoke and was just mesmerized.
Then came the explosions.
A dull, like, boom, but I'd say I counted probably close to like a half a dozen before I even left my house.
Those booms were bursting oil drums coming from inside this warehouse in the center of Homer City. Two businesses, Accent Oil and a flooring company, occupy the building.
It's just so emotional.
For Merlo, it's tough to watch, tougher to talk about.
We're lucky there wasn't any loss of life.
As the fire raged, concern turned towards protecting nearby houses, like the one Ben Day lives in.
It didn't look good. Well, you can see it's total loss.
Firefighters evacuated 12 people on this street as a precaution.
They were a little shaken, you know, obviously at that time of morning, getting to wake up, looking out your window, and you see the building across the street glowing.
We kept an eye on it, and most of the street evacuated down in front of our house, so we commiserated.
Now it's safe for Day and his neighbors to go back home, though many can't tear their eyes away from the destruction.
It's tough in a town like Homer City. I mean, this building's been here for years. You'd never think that something of this caliber would ever happen.
Back out live, see that slick sheen, that murky water right there? Well, that's the oil that came from the drums that firefighters were concerned about. They had hazmat teams out here to make sure that did not get into the creek nearby, that didn't get into the water system nearby, and they said that has been contained. It's not an issue, so residents out here in Indiana County should not be worried. For now, reporting live here in Indiana County, I'm Courtney Fisher, Channel 4 Action News.